Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the numerical integration. Today we will discuss about how we can construct the MATLAB code of Simpson 3x8 rule. That's a part of the numerical method. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there if you feel any doubt regarding MATLAB programming. So first of all, what is the numerical integration and why it's so important? So in mathematics, this numerical integration is used to compute the approximate value of the definite integral, that is integration from a to b f of x of dx. So once we are using this approximate integration, there are the numerous methods exist, such as the composite trapezoidal rule, Simpson 1/3 rule, Simpson 3x8 rule, and many more are there. And the function which are used in the f of x, this is the function f of x. If we approximate this f of x by a linear function, then the method is called as the composite trapezoidal rule. If we use the parabolic function to approximate the integral, then the call as the 1/3 rule. While in this Simpson 3x8 rule, we use this cubic function. And so that the differences of the higher order, for example, if you talk about the linear function, then the order of 2 and the whole and the highers are become 0. Similarly, for the cubic function, the order of 4 and the higher order becomes the 0. And the last two lectures related to the MATLAB code of the trapezoidal and the Simpson 1/3 rule is available on my YouTube channel. The link is given here, or else you can see in the description part. Now, what is the target of this lecture is, we will discuss how we can construct the MATLAB code of Simpson 1/3 rule by using the cubic function. So what is the formula for the Simpson 3x8 rule is, we will see there is a 3x8, that's why we call it as the Simpson 3x8 rule. Here the integration is from a to b, so this is a function value at f of a and the upper value. And the inside values are the 2 times all those which are the multiples of the 3, while the others are whatever the others, that is called as the y1, y2, y4, apart from the y3, y6, where yk is nothing but function at, if you have the function from f of x of dx, then what is the value of at a plus kh, where h is nothing but my b minus a upon n, where n is the number of the subintervals. So our target is to write this MATLAB equations, write this equation in the MATLAB window. That's a very simple, but before using the Simpson 3x8 rule, you must know that this method is applicable only when you define n as a multiple of the 3 in the MATLAB programming or in the theory of class. Like you can set n either as a 3, 6, 9 and so on. While in the Simpson 1/3 rule, we have seen that n is applicable only for the even number of the partitions. That is, you have to divide the intervals a, b into the multiples of the 3. So what is the algorithm is, how you can construct the MATLAB code? I can define you the three step rule are there. The first step is, you have to define whatever the function you have, f of x, what is the lower limit and the upper limit, and how many sub intervals you needed to compute this approximate value of the integral. So first step is, you have to input this. After that, you have to compute the value of the h by using b minus a by n and check whether n is a multiple of the 3 or not. If n is not the multiple of the 3, then you have to reassign the value of the n, and if it is the multiple of 3, then go to the step number 3. In the step number 3, we compute firstly the value of the yk by using this expression, and then we will implement this expression into the MATLAB. So look at that, how we can solve such problem in the MATLAB. So I can explain you with some arbitrary example, like here the function integrate from 1 to 2 e of x upon this, so by using Simpson 3x8 rule. And remember that we have to implement this way. So how you can start in the MATLAB window? If you open the MATLAB window here, you can start from the format short. Firstly, what is the meaning of the format short is, if you want to display all your results in the 4 decimal, look at that. If I just write 1/3, you can see the results are up to the 4 decimal. But if you want to write a format long, it means the results will be up to 16 decimal places. Also, if you want to write the format long e, what is the meaning of the e is exponential part. You can see I can write this function that 10 raised to power minus 1. Here, e of minus 1 implies 10 raised to power minus 1. So you can see that. So x depending upon your problem, you can write either as a format short, long, and whatever. Now you have to clear all those stored variable. Look at that. In this case, if you write the ans, now ans is stored in the form of here. So I have to firstly clear all these stored variables like here. Now if I write ans, it will be nothing is there. You can see nothing is appear here. Also, if you want to clear the screen, this is clear the screen. You can see there are so many returns are there. Now if I write here as a CLC, now the clear will screen will be clear. Now first of all, you have to define your function, whatever the function you have. If I have the e raised power x upon 1 plus x, you have to write the function at the rate of this, like f is at the rate of x. This is the function. What is the meaning of the at the rate? Is function of the x. E raised power x, that is the exponential, exp of exponential divided by 1 plus x. I have used the dot sign. So you can see I can write here as exp. Why I taken as a dot? That's the element wise multiplied. So this is the function of the here. Then you have to define the value of a. You can define a either as a 1 simply, b either as a 2, or else you can take the input from the user, like a is input, enter the lower limits of a. So if I write for you here as input, say enter a, so what will happen if I press the enter? Sorry, it's a input. So if I press the enter, it will ask you enter the value of a. You can write and a as a 2, a as a 1, and so on. So it will store whatever you input, that's stored in the form of a. Similarly, you can put the input as enter the value of the b, and you can put up the enter the value of the n, that is a enter the number of the sub interval. So this is my step one. Now what is the step number two? Is we have to define the value of the h, like b minus a divided by n. And then what is the step number two? Is we have also checked whether the n is a multiple of the 3 or not. How you check that whether it's a multiple of the 3? We have to use this command rem, that is called as the remainder. When you divide n with the 3, look at that. If I set here as n is say my 6, okay, so if I write n comma 3, what is the remainder when you divide 6 by 3? Answer is 0. You can see that. But if I say n is my 7, and if you divide n by 3, what is the meaning? What is the remainder when you divide n by 3? Answer is 1. If you set n as my 5, then what is the remainder of 7 of n comma 3? It will be the 2. So this remainder will call as the REM is called as the remainder. And what will happen if it is 0? What is the meaning of that? It means the number which you have chosen is divisible by 3. So you can say thanks, it's a valid n, and then we will proceed. Otherwise, if this is not be a 0, then we can say please enter the valid n, or else if so, then you have to input the again value, input, enter the n as a multiple of the 3. Now once you will define the n and so on, then we will define this expression. How we can define? So look at that. Firstly, we need to calculate yk. So I have to write k as 1 to n minus 1. So I think all of you know this is the meaning of the increment. Like here, if I write here as 1 to 7, 6, so what is the meaning of that? It is an increment of 1, 1, 1, and so on. But if I write here as a 2, then it means the first number is 1, then 3, after that 2, 2 sides are there. If I write here as say my 16, then the numbers are 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, and so on. Once you will write here, then our target is to write this value. So since my function f is denoted in the form of the f also, so you have to call this. I denoted as compute the yk, that is here. I code as a s, f of a plus k dot h, that is element wise. Now in order to express this, what we'll do, you need to compute only for the 3, whatever the number, these are all the values. Among all those, we have to separate the values as y3, y6, and yn-1, and y1, y2, y4, all are separate. So I can define the index I, which is used for here, that is a 3, start from the 3, ending at n-1, and the difference is my 3. So I can write here as a 3, 3, 3. So you can see, I can write here as a 3, 3, and number is say my 17. So you can see the 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. So this 3, 3, 3 is defined for here. So I denoted this as my I. So it means this is the value corresponding to this. Now I can find the sum of all those values of the y. Y is denoted in the sum of s. So I can write here, or you can also write in form of this sum of s of I. Why? Because this number is nothing but my I. So either you can write this or this. So what is the meaning of the S3? It will give you this green values are there. It will give, now once you written as sum, it will calculate you Y3, Y6 and so on. Now the remaining thing is you have to find Y1, Y2, Y4, that is 3 missing. Similarly Y5, Y6 missing. It means I have to delete all those values of the I. How I can delete is, I can write S of I is empty. What is the meaning of that? If I write here as say S is my 1 to 1 to say 9, and I define I as my say 3 of say 9. So if you write here S, you can see all those numbers of the S. So if I write here S of I is empty, what is the meaning of the I is? You can see the number is 3, this is my I, this is my I. Now if you write here as empty, it will be delete the number of the S I. So if you write the enter, you can see the value of the, you can see the 3 is deleted. You can see 6 is deleted and so on. So in order to delete this particular number, that is 1, 2, 4, 6, I have to use this command. That is a delete the value at the ith position. Ith position is 3, 3, 3. So it means now the S value is written by Y1, Y2, Y4. Now in order to find the sum, that is a sum, I have to use the command as SUM, sum of the S. So once you will written as SO, O is called as the others, S of the others. Now once you will compute this expression, once you already compute this expression, so F of A you already know, so we can write this Simpson 3 by 8 rule here. How we can write that? I can denote it as a OUT output. 3H by 8, so 3 multiply H divided by 8, multiply F of A, so F A I already input, plus F of B, plus 3 times Y1, Y2, Y4, which are all stored in the form of the SO. So I written as 3 dot of SO, plus Y3, Y6, Y9, and all are stored in the form of S3. So I written as 2 into S of 3. Now finally, once you compute this value, you can print the output as the value of the integration is percentage of the F. F is used for the decimal part of the out whatever you have stored here. So this is a simple MATLAB code of this. I hope you will be happy after learning this window. So if you see, I can run on this file on the MATLAB window. You can see I have complete the whatever I have explained. I have written all this in here. Now if I run this file for this part, exponential of x of this, now once I will run here, it will ask you input the value of a. So you can see my input is my 1. So a is my 1. So once I will input a, what is my b is my 2. So if I input as a 1, upper is 2, enter a sub intervals, I say is my 20. Now you can see this is not the divisible by 3. So you can see please enter a valid n. So enter the number which is multiple of the 3. So I can say it's a 15. So now after writing the 15, your answer will be here. It means the integration of this by consider the 15 sub interval is my here. On the other hand, if you run this file again, I can say 1, upper limit is 2. I can take as my 12, which is itself a divisible by 3. So they will say thanks, it's a valid n. So the value of the answer is my here. On the other hand, if you want to integrate this function by here instead of this, so you have to only change this function. The function is my cos x minus log x. That is, your function will be here as a cos x minus log x plus e raised power x of the integration from 1 to 2 by using Simpson 1/3 rule. So I have to replace this function with the help of here. So that is like here, f at the rate is cos x minus log x and so on. So if you run the file again, you can see enter the limit is 1, enter the limit is upper 2, sub interval is say my 23, which is not divisible by 3, enter the valid n. So I valid n is my say 12, so you will get the required answer. So this is the simple way are there. If you want to find some more videos related to this, you can simply follow this playlist and the channel name is here, and where you can find the complete numerical analysis, bisection, regular falsi, Gauss elimination, so on, and trapezoidal and many more. Till then, you can simply follow this link for finding these videos are there. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.